Hello people, in this video we want to look at lens induced glaucomas. What induced glaucomas? Glaucomas because of lens. Which lens? The crystalline lens in the eye. Here you can see the eye and here you can see the lens, right? So this lens can cause glaucoma, right? Why? How? How can this lens cause glaucoma? So that is what we are looking at here. Basically, where are we? We are looking at secondary glaucomas. See, secondary glaucoma. In secondary glaucoma, that means there is an underlying known cause, right? In that you have lens-induced glaucomas. These are also called as phacogenic glaucomas. What glaucomas are these? Phacogenic, because of the lens, right? Phacogenic glaucomas. So under lens-induced glaucomas, that is phacogenic glaucomas, we have the following, okay? We have lens-induced secondary angle closure glaucoma, open angle glaucoma. So you have only two types, right? Open angle and angle closure. Now, when will the angle close and when will the angle be open? So under the, so let us look at this angle closure. When will angle close? Phacomorphic glaucoma, this lens is swollen or there is anterior displacement of lens. So there is angle closure. So look at this, this lens became swollen, right? So what happens when this lens becomes swollen? There is angle closure. So because of which you can have angle closure glaucoma. Because of what? Lens being swollen. That is phacomorphic. Then you have anterior displacement of the lens. So when there is anterior displacement of the lens, angle is closed. So there can be angle closure glaucoma. That is very simple, right? So you have phacomorphic due to swollen lens and phacotopic due to anterior lens displacement. When will the lens get swollen? See, swollen lens usually happens in intumescent cataract, right? That is mature cataract. So the lens absorbs water and it becomes big. So that is phacomorphic. Also, as and when we age, that lens will go on becoming big, right? That is coming under primary, right? That is coming under primary angle closure glaucoma, they put that. But this one, because of lens, that one is going under phacomorphic secondary angle closure glaucoma. Okay, we are done with this angle closure glaucoma. What is lens-induced secondary open-angle glaucoma? See, open-angle glaucoma means the angle is open, but something is coming in blocking this angle. So, angle is basically open. Something is coming in clogging the trabecular meshwork. So, it can be either lens particles which are coming. Okay. So, that can be called as the, what is this? Phacoantigenic, because of anaphylactic or antigen antibody reaction to the lens particles, that inflammatory material can cause the trabecular meshwork to get blocked. So that will become phacoantigenic. So in open angle, what and all do you have? You have phacolytic lens particle, then you have phacoantigenic, right? So three things in open angle. So we have to look at each of these separately, right? So let us look at each of these separately. So what is phacogenic because of the lens? So this is phacoantigenic. Okay. So there are many terminologies here. You need to focus. Phacogenic is the bigger term. Then you have phacomorphic. Then you have because of the anterior dislocation, that is called as phacotropic. Tropic, right? Tropic. Yeah. Phacotopic. Topic. Okay. Open angle. Open angle, what will you have? Open angle, you have three things. Phacolytic lens particle and phaco anaphylactic or phaco antigenic, right? Very good. So let us quickly look at each of these. Okay, let's start with the first one, that is phacomorphic. So phacomorphic glaucoma means what? The lens is getting swollen. So when will it get swollen? If there is intumescent cataract, that is maturation of cataract. So what will happen? The lens will swell, right? Because of which, what will happen? There is going to be pupillary block. Pupillary block and iris bombae formation. That's what they are saying here. Pupillary block, iris bombae formation. So what is this pupillary block? So this iris is kind of synecate is happened here. So there is a block and aqueous is accumulating in at the back. So there is bulging of this iris. So that is called as iris bombae. Right? All this you can see. And because of this iris protruding like that, angle will get closed. So it will become intraocular pressure will become more and it can lead to optic nerve damage and visual field defects. Okay, so what is this? This is a phacomorphic glaucoma. Note ciliary congestion, the ciliary congestion, dilated pupil, intumescent senile cataractous lens. So you can see the lens is intermittent senile cataractus. It is opaque, so it is cataractus lens. Okay, so what will happen to these people? Very typical angle closure symptoms. What will they have? Pain because of this increased IOP, which is sudden. They can have colored halos. They will see colored halos, blurred vision because they already have cataract also, and now this corneal edema. Then congestion. You can see the congestion here. Raised intraocular pressure, pupillary block. They already told you. Large vertically oval pupil. Remember, this is very important. An angle closure, right? You will have vertically oval pupil and intermittent lens. Here you will see intermittent lens. So how will you treat these people? Basically, standard glaucoma treatment. You can write here everything. And you can say IV mannitol, acetazolamide, because it is an angle closure, right? And then topical beta blockers, laser iridotomy they can do, so that they can basically, iridotomy means they make a hole in the iris, right? Usually in the top part, so that there can be aqueous humor can drain, right? Okay, so basically it was the iris which was blocking the way, right? So now they have made a hole, bypass the pupil, come out of the iris, and the aqueous humor should get out. Cataract lens extraction with implantation of PCIOL. Basically, this is anyways cataractus, so you remove this lens and give them a PCIOL. Okay, so that is what is phacomorphic glaucoma. It's a secondary angle closure glaucoma. Okay, so let's move on, guys. We are done with the phacomorphic. Okay, now let's move on. Phacolytic is the lens protein glaucoma, guys. This is also called as lens protein glaucoma, phacolytic. So where are we now? We have reached the open angle ones. Okay, see, phacomorphic swollen lens, phacotopic anterior displacement. So these two will cause angle closure. We are done with this. Now we are going to the open angle one. Open angle, we are going to look at phacolytic now. Okay, so phacolytic, let's move on to phacolytic. Yeah, also called as lens protein glaucoma. The lens protein is leaking out of the lens, right? You can see here some kind, but the capsule is intact here, or there is very small micro leaks of what? Of not the lens particle here, it is the lens protein. Remember, it's not lens particle, it's the lens protein. These proteins are heavy molecular weight, high molecular weight lens proteins. And what do these particles do? They come out, these proteins, they come out and they block the trabecular meshwork. Angle is open, trabecular meshwork is blocked. So glaucoma. So basically, when will you see this lens protein coming out? In hypermature Morganian cataract. Remember this one. So you can see here, hypermature Morganian cataract. So what has happened? The nucleus has dipped inside this cortex, which has liquefied, right? So now what happens? The proteins start leaking out and they will block the trabecular meshwork. Okay, so basically here you can see anterior chamber is deep, because you can say open angle, that's what it will be like. And the aqueous, you will see white protein particles. So in the aqueous, you can see white protein particles, and they can also settle down as pseudo hypopyon, they are seen. Okay, so white particles here as a pseudo hypopyon, they can sit here. White, please give white. Yeah, see here, white here, hypopyon. Okay guys, so how will you know that the angle is open? Via gonioscopy. That much and all we already know, because we have already studied open angle and closed angle glaucomas, right? Primary. How will you manage this? Very similar. You will reduce, giving anti-glaucoma drugs to reduce the IOP. Then you have to extract this hypermature cataract, right? Hypermature cataract, you have to extract and put a IOL. So phacolytic, did you understand? Phacolytic is actually protein, okay? Then we are moving on to lens particle glaucoma. Here the lens particles, the particles itself are coming out, right? It's not the protein, something like even bigger, the particle, right? The particle itself, the fragments of lens, okay? So basically what happened, somebody had a cataract surgery, let's say, and they have made this hole, right, in the capsule, in the anterior capsule, to put the PCIOL, so, or to extract the lens. So this hole they have created. So this means to say that there has been a surgery, but this fragments of lens, or the particles of lens, got left. Okay, they got left there, right? After in the cataract extraction, they got left there. So these lens particles will block the trabecular meshwork. The angle is open, remember, and it will lead to secondary open angle glaucoma. Okay, here what you will do, same type of treatment, same thing, everything same. You can aspirate these lens particles, okay, from the aqueous. because these are not going to increase or anything, right? So they have been left out there, so you just remove them. So lens particle, can you say particle? Particle got means lens particle glaucoma means, you remember, these particles got left behind, right? So that's what you have to remember. So this is the lens particle glaucoma. This looks bad. Okay. Then last one is phacoantigenic. Okay, previously called anaphylactic glaucoma. So guys, we are looking at what now? Phacoantigenic. Okay. So there is an antigen antibody reaction. Reaction to what? The lens protein. So you know our body protects the lens protein inside, etc. And they are avascular structures, right? Lens and all. So we don't get exposed to these lens particles. But what happens if the lens particles or the lens proteins get, they get exposed to our body, and our body starts thinking that it is a foreign body, and there is an antigen antibody reaction. So that will lead to inflammation, right? So that inflammation can cause the clogging of the trabecular meshwork, leading to glaucoma. Okay. So basically what they are telling here is, how does this lens protein get out? That too they are saying, the vitreous plus lens protein combination, that is what is triggering the inflammation. So basically in the cataract surgery, something happened to the posterior capsule. A little of these lens proteins have leaked into the vitreous humor. So this now gets attacked by the body because it is an antigen antibody reaction, and this inflammatory material will lead to trabecular meshwork blockage, leading to glaucoma. Okay. So that is the, which one? Phacoantigenic, that is phacoanaphylactic glaucoma. Inflammatory reaction due to antigen, lens protein antibody reaction. Granulomatous inflammation. Guys, this word is very important. What inflammation is it here? It's granulomatous inflammation. Surgical trauma, remember. Penetrating injury also probably can happen. So proteins from the capsule, they're saying, oh, it is not the lens proteins. They're saying it is the capsule proteins, is it? Well, here they are saying lens protein, here they are saying capsular protein, but something is triggering the antigen antibody reaction, remember, and causing inflammation. So remember, this can happen usually 2 weeks after cataract surgery. They can say there can be uveitis inflammation, right? And whenever there is anterior uveitis, what will you see? Mutton fat, KPs, etc. How will you manage this? Again, you have to aspirate this lens matter from the anterior chamber, and you will treat it similarly, all the anti-glaucoma drugs, etc. Here they are talking about steroids also, because there is inflammation, right? Cycloplegics to reduce the pain, etc. How's it, guys? We finished lens-induced glaucoma. Let's take a recap. Let's take a recap, guys. So basically, in secondary glaucomas, you have lens-induced or phacogenic glaucomas. So basically, here lens-induced phacogenic glaucomas, it is because of the lens. This is secondary glaucoma because you kind of know the underlying cause. So the lens can cause angle closure glaucoma or open angle glaucoma. Secondary angle closure glaucoma, you have phacomorphic glaucoma and phacotopic glaucoma. Phacomorphic glaucoma, the lens is swelling up and it is closing the angle. This happens in mature cataract, intumescent. And phacotopic glaucoma is where the lens itself is anteriorly displaced, hence it is closing the angle, leading to glaucoma. What is lens-induced secondary open angle glaucoma? You can have phacolytic glaucoma. This is because of lens proteins, right? And then you have lens particle glaucoma. This is because of lens fragments, you can say, after cataract surgery, they got left out. So lens particle glaucoma, lens fragments left inside cataract surgery. Then you have phacoantigenic anaphylactic glaucoma. There is reaction of the lens protein with the vitreous and some inflammatory antigen antibody reaction, leading to trabecular meshwork getting clogged, leading to glaucoma. Okay. So phacomorphic, you saw, intumescent cataract, the swollen cataract is lens, will lead to the angle closure. This will happen in mature cataract. So pupillary block, iris bombae formation, etc. You can treat with standard things, and you can anyways remove the cataract and give PCIOL. Phacolytic glaucoma, lens protein glaucoma. The lens protein keeps leaking through an intact capsule, remember. This will happen in hypermature Morgagnon cataract. Then what happens here? These particles which are leaking, the lens proteins will clog the trabecular meshwork and lead to glaucoma. Again, here you will treat the cataract. lens particle glaucoma. Basically, here it's an open angle glaucoma where the capsulotomy has been done, right? There is a lens particle which got left out during the surgery, which are now coming and causing this trabecular meshwork clog and glaucoma. Okay, how will you treat it? Irrigation aspiration of the lens particles. Lastly, guys, we are looking at phacoantigenic glaucoma. It's also anaphylactic. Basically, here there's antigen antibody reaction. Okay, guys, so we are at the last one. What are we looking at? Phacoantigenic glaucoma. Basically, inflammatory reaction to what? To the lens particle. So, antigen antibody reaction. This will cause granulomatous inflammation. Very important word you have to write here. So, basically, because of penetrating injury or some surgical trauma, there is leak of proteins from the capsule, right? So after 2 weeks after this, there is inflammation, reaction of the uveal tissue, so uveitis, right? So the trabecular meshwork will get clogged by the inflammatory cells and the lens particles. So the trabecular meshwork in this case is getting in, clogged by two things, the lens particles and also the inflammatory cells, right? So again, standard therapy. But here they're talking about steroids because of inflammation, irrigation aspiration of the lens matter from anterior chamber. Okay, should be done after proper control of inflammation. So that's it in lens induced glaucoma, right? Bye bye.